بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد، continuing on in our treatise, our study of Aqidat al-Wasatiyya by Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, we reach the last chapter regarding those verses which affirm Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's divine attributes and names, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in this portion of the treatise, Shaykh al-Islam rahimahullah ta'ala referred to the believers seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment. And this is affirmed from the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam, and that we have not seen Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we do not see our Lord in this life, but however in the hereafter, the believers will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is one of the great blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon His creation for those who believe amongst them. And Shaykh al-Islam mentioned the verse where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَجُوهٌ يَوْمَئِذٍ نَاظِرَةٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا نَاظِرَةٌ. And where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فِي كِتَابِهِ الْكِرِيمِ عَلَىٰ الْأَرَائِكِ يَنْظُرُونَ وَقَوْلُهُ لِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا حُسْنًا وَزِيَادَةً وَقَوْلُهُ وَلَهُمْ مَا يَشَاءُونَ فِيهَا وَلَدَيْنَا مَزِيدٌ. And those are some of the verses. And as Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah mentioned, he said, وَهَذَا الْبَابِ فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ كَثِيرًا مَنْ تَدَبَّرَ الْقُرْآنَ طَالِبًا لِلْهُدَى مِنْهُ تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ طَرِيقَ الْحَقِّ. And that's a beautiful statement by Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. He said, for the one who ponders and contemplates those verses from the Kitabillah, from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meaning the Quran, if they reflect and they're seeking guidance, he said, طَالِبٍ لِلْحَقِّ. So this is how they would reflect. They reflect by seeking the truth, not just reflecting on and just anything that comes to their mind and comes to their intellect to go with that, but rather they reflect upon the ayats, seeking the truth from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, then the person who does this, then the path of the truth will become clear to them. So by contemplating the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will affirm those attributes as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala affirmed them about Himself, and as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam affirmed those same ayats. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the verses that we mentioned, in the above verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the first verse, He said, some faces that day shall be shining and radiant, looking at their Lord. And that's referring to the believers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another verse, on high thrones, looking at all things. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another verse, for those who have done good is the best reward and even more. Meaning to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the Mufassirin explained. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, there they will have all that they desire, and we have more for them. Meaning to glance at Allah the Almighty, the All-Majestic, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Shaykh al-Islam said, there is a great deal in the Qur'an in the subject. Whoever will endeavor to seek guidance from the Qur'an, the path of the truth, will be clear before him. So this is a benefit for us in order to, whenever we want to seek the truth, that we should read the Qur'an and read the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and then reflect upon it with our hearts open to the truth. No matter what aspect of the religion we're referring to, that we should go with the Nusus, the text, the Qur'an and the Sunnah, and then from there we contemplate. And from there, and we have our intention pure, to ask Allah for the truth so that we don't be led astray. Look at those who are not favored to have the creed and the aqidah of Ahl Sunnati wal Jama'ah. Look at all the groups and sects in this time and those who came before us. Like, as we mentioned on countless occasions, the Jahmiyyah, the Mu'tazila, the Asha'ira, the Kulabiyya, the Maturidiyya. Now we have other groups that spun off of them that hold the same aqidah in essence. We have Diobandis, we have Naqshbandi Sufis, we have many, many sects and stuff that go astray with regards to the divine attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we have the Ahbash that was led by, this is a more modern sect that had went far astray from Kitabillah wa Sunnatu Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? Because they let their intellect overrule the text, the Nasus. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about Himself that the believers will see Him on the day of resurrection, they make ta'wil, they explain it to fit their aql, to fit their intellect. And some of the arguments, as Sheikh Salim Ibn Fawzan mentions in his explanation of this very important treatise, Aqidat al-Wasatiyah, he mentioned some very important benefits for us that we can gain from those verses. Qala Shaykh Salim al-Fawzan, he said, ما يستفاد من الآيات الكريمة. He said, what we benefit from these divine, beautiful verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, we benefit, يستفاد منها إثبات رؤية المؤمنين. إثبات رؤية المؤمنين لربهم يوم القيامة. That one of the things we benefit is that these verses affirm for us that the believers will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment. And another benefit, Imam Fawzan said, Hafidhullah ta'ala, he said, وَأَنَّهَا أَعْظَمَ نَعِيمَ الَّذِي يَنَالُونَهُ. That he mentioned that this is one of the greatest blessings that the believer could ever have, which is to see his Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment. So that is a great ni'mah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for the believers, that one day they will be graced and blessed to be able to see their Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, who we didn't see in the dunya, who we worshipped in the day and in the night, believing in Him, but we never saw our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we believed in Him from the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And in addition to that, the Shaykh mentions, he said, وَهَذَا هُوَ قَوْلَ السَّحَابَ وَتَابِعِينَ وَأَئِمَّةُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. He said, and this is the statement of the Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, and the Tabi'een rahimahumullah jami'an, and the A'immatu Muslimin, and the Imams of the Muslims. This is imperative for us to understand this, that this is not the qawl, this is not the statement of just some of the scholars of today, but these are the statements, these concepts in Aqidah, they come from the Sahaba. Sahaba to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, who were with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who were there when revelation came down. They were in the presence of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they had the sweetness of being around the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his companionship radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een. So they understood the Quran more than we understand the Quran. They were there, they knew the asbab and nuzul, they knew the reasons the Quran was revealed, because they were there in those particular instances and situations, and they had the explanation of the Quran, which we have to take from their explanation, not those people who came later who explained things based upon their ra'y, based upon their opinion, based upon their aql, based upon their limited intellect. But rather we go as the Imam Salih bin Fawzan hafidhullah ta'ala, he mentioned, he said, يستفاد منها إثبات رؤية المؤمنين لربهم يوم القيامة. That what we benefit from these ayats is that it affirms for us that the believers will see their Lord on the Day of Judgment. وَأَنْهَا أَعْظَمَ نَعِيمٍ, and that is one of the greatest blessings. وَهَذَا هُوَ قَوْلُ الصَّحَابَةِ, and that is the statement of the companions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم رضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين. And then who? وَالتَّابِعِينَ, and then the Tabi'een. rahimahullah ta'ala. And then who? Wa'immata muslimin, and the imams of the Muslims. Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi'i, Imam Ahmed, rahimahumullah jami'an. And the a'imma that came after them, rahimahumullah jami'an. So this shows us that this is the creed of Ahl Sunnah. And as Imam Fawzan says, خلافاً للرافضة وجهمية ومعتزلة الذين ينفون رؤية ويخالفون بذلك الكتاب والسنة والإجماع السلف الأمة وأئمتها. He said, and this differs, meaning this ithbat, this affirmation of seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the Day of Judgment, this differs from the statements and aqidah, the i'tiqad of the Rafida, Shia, the Jahmiya, who are the Mu'attila, and the Mu'tazila, those also who are Mu'attila, those people who negate seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and through their negation, they differ, and they go against, and they are the opposite in creed of who? Of the Quran, of the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the ijma, the consensus of the Salaf, of the Sahaba and the companions, the Tabi'een and Itba' Tabi'een. So they contradict their understanding and what the Quran says and what the Sunnah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, and what the a'immat ad-deen, the imams of the religion, what they have stated and what they believe and what they propagate and what they deduced from the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. So those groups, they differ with Ahl Sunnah Rasul sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. And a beautiful faida Sheikh Salim bin Fawzan mentions, he also mentions, he said regarding their statement, because those groups and even the Asha'ira, they say this, and this is very important for us to understand this. He said, وَقَوْلِهِمْ إِنَّ الْإِثْبَاتَ رُؤْيَا يَلْزِمْ مِنْهُ إِثْبَاتَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ فِي جِهَا وَلَوْ كَانَ فِي جِهَا لَكَانَ جِسْمًا وَاللَّهُ مُنَزِّهُ عَنْ ذَلِكَ. So the statement, and this is where we find a lot of those people who, many of the Asha'ira and many of these other sects who negate many of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's divine attributes and sifat by saying that by affirming those sifat, you've made a resemblance to the creation. And so here's what they say regarding the Ru'ya. So they differ with Ahl Sunnah, as we've already made clear what Ahl Sunnah believes. That they believe that by affirming the Ru'ya, affirming that the believers will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the Day of Judgment, that you are affirming that Allah is in a place or is in a direction. And by affirming that, this is their argumentation, that if Allah is in a direction, then that means He has a body. This is what they say. And this is why they claim and slander Ahl Sunnah and slander Imam Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah ta'ala, with being mujassima. So this is how we can understand this argument. Because again, it shows you their whole minhaj, their whole methodology. They take their intellect and they, with their deductive reasoning, they deduce that Ahl Sunnah is from the mujassima. And they are in fact claiming that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was mujassima. This is what they are saying in essence. Because they are deducing that by, if we follow and affirm what Allah affirms about Himself and what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam affirms about Him, then we're mujassima. وَعِيَادَ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. But in fact, this is according to their reasoning and their intellect. Because Ahl Sunnah says Allah is free from that, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declares for Himself that He is free from these false claims of shirk and false claims of making tashbih. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٌ وَهُوَ سَمِيعٌ بَصِيرٌ وَهُوَ سَمِيعٌ بَصِيرٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, there is none, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ, there's none that resembles Him. And then He affirms for Himself that He is the all-hearing, He is the all-seeing, that He has those attributes, He has divine attributes, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that doesn't mean the fact that Allah has divine attributes that we can make all kind of deductions and say the attributes are like his creation, or that the creation's attributes are like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's attributes. Yes, we have attributes and Allah has attributes, but our attributes are unlike Allah's, and Allah's attributes are unlike his creation, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's attributes are perfect, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's attributes are deduced from Quran, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's attributes are deduced from the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is and what the salaf of this ummah, salaf as-salih, what they understood from those ayats of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Ahl Sunnah stops there. We stop there. We don't go beyond the text. Whereas Ahl Bidah, wa Zandaka, wa Ilhad, that they go beyond the text. They use their intellect and their aql to deduce and make false claims against Ahl Sunnah, and to make false claims against, in fact, the Quran, and against the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala affirms these attributes for himself, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam affirmed these attributes for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we affirm these attributes for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he affirms them for himself, and as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam affirmed them, and we negate those things which have any concept of imperfection and that are negated by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and negated by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam and the salaf of this ummah. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept this good and forgive our evil. Thus ends the portion of Aqidat al-Wasatiyah, which uses the evidences strictly from the Quran, and that shows us something, the power of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah's his istidlal and his istinbat, that his usage of the Quran and the Sunnah in accordance with the salaf of this ummah was so strong because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala favored him to be Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, favored him with these characteristics of being able to understand how the salaf of this ummah how they understood and propagated the aqidah of Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah, and he understood those funoon in regarding Islam. He was Shaykh al-Islam, not just in aqidah, but he was profound in his argumentation and in us understanding the arguments of Ahl al-Bidah wa Zandaka and Kufr. He understood there wasn't a fin, there wasn't a art, if you will, or a science in Islam that Allah didn't favor him to be profound in. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala favored Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah with profound ilm and fiqh fi deen. And as Allah subhanahu, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من يرد الله به خيرا يفقه في الدين. Whenever Allah wants good for his slave, he gives him understanding of the religion. And we benefit greatly from the books of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. And our next dars will continue on and going from the evidences for those attributes that we mentioned from the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, again showing us the power of istidlal from Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Anything I said that was correct was from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything I said that was incorrect were from myself and the shaitan. Wa sallallahu wasallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.